A point-of-sale system, or POS for short, has become an essential tool for businesses big and small. It's faster, saves time, and it's a system that comes with some interesting features, which we'll highlight later. Hi, I'm Ryan from Webiotic. In this video, we'll review how you can get started with developing a mobile POS app. A mobile POS app, also referred to as mPOS, is an incredibly useful tool for businesses that require transactions on the go, such as repair services, food trucks, and market vendors. It's fast, easy to use, and much more affordable than a traditional POS system. If you're set on creating a POS app for businesses to use, here are some key features to include: multiple payment options. Offering the ability to accept multiple forms of payment, including mobile wallets like Apple Pay, is a great feature. The ability to access data. A major benefit of using POS apps is that many allow business owners the ability to access and analyze the data gathered from their smartphone, such as customer orders, payment tracking and status, and sales summary, sales reporting, and analytics. This is an excellent feature to offer as it can help your users grow their business. Customer support. Keep in mind that your users are just regular people trying to run a business. They may not be all that tech savvy, and so your app should offer methods to get tech support if there are any issues with the software. Ability to integrate with other software. Your mPOS app should be able to integrate with a third-party application businesses can benefit from, such as e-commerce software or accounting tools. Now, let's take a look at some design principles to consider when designing and developing your app. After all, effective UX and UI are crucial to the user experience. Keep things simple. Whether your app offers few or many features, it should always be designed with simplicity in mind. Tasks within your app should be easy to accomplish and take as few steps as possible. Don't use off-the-beaten-track designs or icons. Findability is key. Make it intuitive. Remember, many of your app's users may not be tech savvy. They want an app that's easy and intuitive to use. Keep designs consistent. Whatever interface elements you use, they should be used consistently throughout the application. Each page should not have new controls. That just adds an extra layer of complexity that isn't necessary. Offer various login personas. Some POS systems offer different types of app users, such as an admin, aka the business owner, employees and staff, and even customers. Each category will allow for different levels of access within the app. So, what about monetizing your POS app? Many of these apps make money by charging a monthly or yearly fee to use the software, but not all. For example, Square's POS doesn't charge any setup fees or monthly fees. One way they make money is by taking a cut of every transaction fee. They also make money by offering various add-ons, like hardware products and plan upgrades, which come with extra features. This is a great monetization method because it starts users for free, only charging them for payment processing, but can easily upsell with their additional features, products, and services. Modern mobile POS systems have enormous potential to offer real value for its users, and they go beyond simple payment processing. These mobile systems are fast, flexible, and provide an opportunity for developers and entrepreneurs to improve the user experience by offering industry-specific features and capabilities. I hope you learned something today about how to develop a mobile POS app. For more help with your app, subscribe to our channel. If you like this video, please like it and share it with others. Thank you for watching.